Last one here is we're given a function. We're asked to write it in this form. So this is one of these sinusoids. So the way we start is we use the sum identity for sine. And how does that go? The sine of alpha plus beta is the sine of alpha times the cosine of beta plus the cosine of alpha times the sine of beta. So I'm going to multiply this out. When I expand this out, rather, I'm thinking of this as being alpha and that being beta. So I'm going to expand it out, multiply it by A. So I get A times sine omega x cosine phi plus A cosine omega x sine phi. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to match it up with f of x equals cosine 7x minus 2 sine 7x. Since these two expressions have to be equal for all x, and what I'm going to do is match up the coefficients of cosine and sine in each of these expressions. So the first thing I'm going to note is I'm looking at the argument of the trig function. Here is 7x. The argument of the trig functions here are omega x. This tells me straight away that omega is 7. Now I look at the coefficient here of cosine 7x. In f of x, excuse me, in s of x, the coefficient of the cosine omega x term is a sine phi. Here the coefficient is 1, so a sine phi is 1. Now I look at the coefficient of sine 7x. The coefficient of the sine omega x term here is a cosine phi. Down here it's negative 2. All right, now we have a system, two equations and two unknowns, and so we have to eliminate one of the variables. And as we mentioned before in class, we can always eliminate the angle by adding a sine phi squared plus a cosine phi squared. And you go through this, you get a squared sine squared phi plus a squared cosine squared phi. I can factor out the a squared. I'm left with sine squared phi plus cosine squared phi. And so we have some Pythagorean magic here. That's always equal to 1. And so we get that a squared is equal to a sine phi squared plus b cosine phi squared. Now, a sine phi we know is 1, and b cosine phi is negative 2. So this gives me a squared is 1 plus 4, which is 5. And so we can choose a to be plus or minus radical 5. In this case, we'll choose the positive radical 5. So this is giving us the amplitude of this is square root 5. All right, now that I know what a is, I can go back to these equations to determine what the phi is. All right, so now I know that a is square root 5. So this equation becomes square root 5 sine phi is 1, and this equation becomes square root 5 cosine phi is negative 2. So if I solve these for the trig function, I get sine phi is 1 over radical 5, or radical 5 over 5, and then cosine phi is negative 2 over radical 5 is negative 2 over radical 5 over 5. So once again, these aren't common values that we have memorized, so we're going to have to use the inverse trig functions to pin down exactly what these are. Let's first figure out what quadrant phi is in. So if I think back to unit circle, if sine is positive and cosine is negative, that means we're looking at an angle in quadrant 2. And so there are two different ways we can describe this quadrant two angle. We can either use an arc sine function or an arc cosine function. I'm going to choose the arc cosine function because if I use the arc sine function, I'd have the arc sine of radical 5 over 5, and that would give me the reference angle. If I use arc cosine directly, by definition, arc cosine of negative 2 radical 5 over 5 will give me an angle in quadrant 2 whose cosine is that. So I'm going to just choose that for convenience. So that gives me the phi. So I go back to my original function, and I'm set for my final answer. S of x is a cosine, sine omega x plus phi. A we picked to be the square root of 5. Sine omega is 7x plus phi, the arc cosine of negative 2 radical 5 over 5. Now, one way we could check this graphically is we could use our calculators. We can graph the f of x, and we can graph this function and see that they're identical graphs. The other way, if we want to check it analytically, is to start with this. Use the sum identity for sine that we have here, and then simplify the resulting formulas. So we need to know the sine of the arc cosine and all that good stuff, and we should simplify back down to here. So we'll leave that to you. That'll do it for Checkpoint Quiz 10.6.